Joining us today, as always, is the classic Abby St. John for this week's entertainment panel, and we are doing it on a Thursday instead of a Friday, but technically, I guess today is still this week's Friday, so it still works out. So thank you so much for joining us today, Abby.
Of course, no worries.
Now, starting off, we got some interesting topics, as we always do, and I always say this, but starting off online, there is some crazy talk on this new film, Everything Everywhere All at Once. And if you even just look at the trailer, it absolutely looks wild. Like, you could tell it does have to do with the multiverse, and it's an action sci-fi kind of thing. And it looks interesting for sure. Fascinating. No idea what this plot is really about, but the reviews online are crazy.
Yes. Yes. This movie looks wild. I watched the trailer for it, and I had to rewatch the trailer for it because I thought it was just the weirdest idea ever. A24 films, it, like you said, deals with the multiverse. Evelyn Wang is trying to pay her taxes, and she gets thrusted into the multiverse and honing the skills of the different versions of herself from the different universes to defeat this evil force in this sci-fi comedy, I think is hilarious. Just watching the trailer, I'm sold. I want to see this movie. It looks fantastic. It's certified fresh on Rotten Tomatoes with a 96% critic rating and a 94% audience rating. So both critics and audiences are really enjoying this film. Lots of critics and reviews are saying that the performance by Michelle Yeoh, who plays Evelyn, was outstanding. And just by watching the trailer, I can already agree that she's fantastic. Jamie Lee Curtis is also in it, and you know, anyone who's watched Jamie Lee Curtis,
no idea Jamie
was in it. She is fantastic in anything she does, so her being signed on to this film sells me already. But people are really liking this movie, and I think it's different. I think it's hilarious. It looks hilarious. You know, you have that sci-fi, and you know, the effects and the CGI just in the trailer alone just looks spectacular. And I think this is a different movie. If the trailer sells it enough, I think this will be a fantastic movie to see. And, you know, the critics are already saying that it's fantastic and audiences are obviously loving it. So it's definitely worth the checking out.
Yeah, I agree with that. The plot, especially what it looks like with the multiverse, you know, it's not just in Marvel anymore, superhero stuff. Now they're bringing it out, and it's good to see those original plots, like original ideas coming out into play for movies, because, you know, there's so many reboots, there's so many continued sequels, all this, but now there's a film out that's like, you know, causing everybody their heads to spin, and they're all like, wow, never would have thought of this as a plot. But, you know, that's a strange topic, but another stranger topic we got going on the go for today is Stranger Things season 4 new trailer that came out a couple days ago, I think on Tuesday. And you know, it's everybody knows now with the volume 1 comes out May 27th on Netflix. But you know, this new trailer shows a lot more than what that original season 4 trailer had, and so much is happening in this from just looking at it. You know, I don't want to do too many spoilers for people that haven't really had the chance to watch the show or watch season 3. But I would suggest going to check that out and watching it now, because this season looks like they say it's a Game of Thrones season coming up here. It seems like there's just a plot with every different character that it's going to focus on.
Yes. You know, from the beginning, from when it was first announced that season 4 is coming out to when they started filming, the actors have been saying from the beginning that this is the most ambitious, this is the scariest, this is, you know, the wildest. Watching this new trailer, it solidifies what they've been saying. Because, you know, it's one thing to hear them saying, oh yeah, this is going to be the most ambitious and the craziest. And it's another thing to actually see it. And just by this trailer alone, it is more wild and crazier looking than all 3 seasons put together, I think. I think this is going to be fantastic. It is, you know, to, again, not give too much away, there's a war with the Upside Down coming. That's what's stated in the trailer. There's a war brewing, and it is coming, and Hawkins is at the hub of it. And like you said, there's going to be different plot and storylines with each kind of group of characters, you know, Hopper in Russia, and then Elle and Joyce and her family are in California, and then the others are still in Hawkins, but they're, you know, they're kind of on the outskirts to kind of keep them safe. So it's going to be interesting to see how they come back together. You know, Elle needs her powers back. So she needs to, you know, she needs to figure that out, because for the last three seasons, her powers are the main reason why they've been able to succeed. So that's going to be interesting to see how that works out and how that molds itself. But this season, I am so excited just by watching the trailer. I think I've watched it three times now. I am so excited for this season for part one, and even more excited for part two. Year every season, the yes. effects get better, you know, the monsters get scarier looking. It's definitely
intense. And I'm excited to see how they will have these characters, like just seeing these characters grow up as well in the show. Of course, they're a lot older than what they portray on TV right now, considering, you know, how long it took them to be able to get the season out. But I think it's going to be amazing. So for everybody out there watching this, make sure to check out Stranger Things and get ready for it, because it's coming on May 27th. But unfortunately, that's all the time we got for this week's entertainment panel. So once again, thank you so much for talking with us today, Abby.
Of course.